Academy YouTube channel. In this session, I am going to discuss image formations by concave and convex mirrors, class 10, NCERT, CBSE, State. ఈ వీడియోను మొదటిసారిగా చూసేవారు దయచేసి లైక్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి, సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి. మీ యొక్క అమూల్యమైన అభిప్రాయాలను మా కామెంట్ సెక్షన్లో తప్పక తెలియజేయండి. ఓకే, లెట్ అస్ గో టు ద టుడే సెషన్. ఇమేజ్ ఫార్మేషన్స్ బై కాన్కేవ్ అండ్ కాన్వెక్స్ మిర్రర్స్, క్లాస్ 10, NCERT, CBSE, స్టేట్. Let us go to that today. Next, image formation by a concave mirror. The ray diagrams for the formation of image by a concave mirror for various positions of the object. Now we are discussing the image formation by a concave mirror. Here we are placing the object at different positions, observing the image by using a concave mirror. Let us discuss one by one. First one, case 1, when the object is at infinity. Now we are placing the object is at infinity, observing the image position by using a concave mirror. See this ray diagram. This is the concave mirror and this is a horizontal line which passes through the center of the concave mirror. Geometric center of the concave mirror is known as a point, that is P, that is known as pole. Geometric center of the spherical mirror is known as pole, and the object is at infinity. Now this is the incident ray coming from the sun. Sun is at infinity, which is the rays are parallel to the principal axis, and this is the direction of the incident ray. This is the incident ray, and one more ray coming from the sun, which is at infinity, and these are the parallel rays. These two are the parallel rays, and this is the direction of the incident ray, and these two are the incident rays. They are touching the reflecting surface of the concave mirror, and they reflected. These reflected rays are meeting at a point. That point is known as focus. It is represented by letter focus. And next, this is a normal. We are drawing the in between incident ray and the reflector ray, and angle of incidence I, angle of reflection R. This is I denotes angle of incidence, R denotes angle of reflection. Angle between incident ray and normal is known as angle of incidence, and angle between normal and reflector ray is known as angle of reflection. This denotes the center of curvature C. So this is the ray diagram for the when the object is at infinity. When the object is at infinity, the rays are coming from the sun. They are parallel rays. These parallel rays are reflecting the reflecting surface. From the reflecting surface, these reflector rays are meeting at a point, focus F. So in this case, image is formed at focus F. The characteristics of image is real, and image is point sized object, and image is highly diminished, and image is formed at focus F. So when the object is at infinity, the image is real, point size diminished, highly diminished, and it is formed at focus F. Okay, now once again, when the object is at infinity, the image is real and diminished, and it is formed at focus F. This is a real image. This is the first case. Next, go to the second case. Case 2, when the object is beyond C. Let us discuss with the ray diagram. What is the image position? This is a concave mirror, and next it is a principal axis, and this is the direction of the principal axis, and it is a point P. P denotes the pole, and then this is the object position, which is beyond C, and this is a ray coming from the object, light ray or incident ray. This is the direction of incident ray, which is parallel to the principal axis, and this is reflector ray, and here we are denoting the points, and this is F, nothing but focus, and reflector ray passing through focus. This is reflector ray. Whenever the incident ray touches the reflecting surface of concave mirror, it reflects. The reflector ray passing through focus. Incident ray parallel to the principal axis, reflector ray passing through the focus. And the next, this is the direction of the reflected ray, and this is the center of curvature C. Center of curvature represents the letter C. One more ray passes through the center of curvature, it retraces its same path. When the object, the two rays are coming from the object, one is parallel to the principal axis, the other one is passing through center of curvature. This is the another ray which passes through the center of curvature, and it retraces its same path. Any ray passing through the center of curvature, it doesn't reflects. So its same path, it reflects, it retraces its same path. In this same path, nothing but through the center of curvature, again it is reflecting the same line, the same path, it retraces its same path. When the object is placed beyond C, the two rays are coming from the object, one is a ray parallel to the principal axis, the reflector ray passing through focus, the another ray passing through the center of curvature, it retraces the same path. Incident ray and reflector ray going the same, incident ray passing through center of curvature, it reflects, and again reflected ray also passing through the center of curvature. So that's why it retraces same path. These two rays are meeting at this point. This point is denoted the image point. Image is inverted image. So the image is real, inverted, and diminished image. This is the object and it is the image. Where the image is formed? Image is formed between C and F. When the object is placed beyond C, the image is formed between C and F. That image is real, inverted, and diminished. And it is formed in between C and F. Okay. Next, we'll go to the third case, when the object is at C. Now let us see the ray diagram for this object. Is at C. This is a concave mirror and it is the principal axis, and point P, P nothing but pole, and then we are taking the center of curvature. Now we are placing the object is at C. Now the first ray parallel to the principal axis, this is incident ray, and these are the directions of incident ray, which is parallel to the principal axis, and reflector ray passing through focus, and this is the direction of the reflector ray, and one more ray passing through the focus, and this is the direction of the incident ray, and these two are the incident rays coming from the object, they are reflecting, and this reflector ray parallel to the principal axis. So first one, the two rays are coming, one is a ray parallel to the principal axis passing through focus, the other one is which is passing through the focus and it is reflector ray parallel to the principal axis. And these two rays, this is the direction of the reflected ray. And these two are here, which is the ray, second ray passing through the focus. And this is the image of the object which is formed at C. Same place, object place, image place, same place and same height. Okay, this is the case 3. When the object is placed at C, the rays are coming from the object. Two rays are coming. One is a ray parallel to the principal axis passing through focus. The other ray passing through focus and reflector ray parallel to the principal axis. These two reflector rays are meeting at this point. This point is known as image point. Image also formed at C, same size, same height. The characteristics of image are, image is formed at C and image is inverted and it is real. Image is real, inverted and same size and which is formed at C. So, when the object is at C, image is formed at C and image is real, same size and inverted. Nothing but real, inverted and same size. Okay. And next, we will go to the next case. Next case 4. When the object is in between the C and F. C means center of curvature and F means focus. Now, we will discuss the image positions in this ray diagram. Let us discuss the ray diagram for this object place. This is concave mirror and this is the horizontal line, principal axis, and this is a point P, and next focus F, and next center of curvature C, and next we are placing the object in between C and F, and one is a ray coming from the object which is passing through the center of curvature, and this is the direction of incident ray and it retraces its same path. Object is passing through the light ray passing through the center of curvature retraces its same path. Next, the second ray, this is the direction of the incident ray, and this is one more ray, this is the direction of incident ray and which is parallel to the principal axis, and it reflects the reflector ray passing through focus. This is the direction of the reflected ray and these two are meeting at this point. This is the image position. Image is inverted and magnified, nothing but enlarged, and it is a real image. So, when the object is in between C and F, the image formed beyond C and the image is a real image and inverted image, real, inverted and magnified image. Image is formed beyond C. Okay. In this case, now we are placing the object in between C and F. One is a ray passing through a center of curvature. It retraces the same path. The another ray, which is parallel to the principal axis, it reflects the reflector ray passing through the focus. And these two reflector rays are meeting at this point. This is the image point and image formed beyond C. This image is a real image, inverted image and magnified image. So, the characteristics of image is, image is real, inverted and magnified, and image is formed beyond C. This is about the, when the object is in between C and F. Next, we will go to the next case. Next, case 5. When the object is at F, now we are placing the object at focus. F nothing but focus. Now see this ray diagram for this object. Now we are finding the image place. See this ray diagram. This is a concave mirror, and it is principal axis. This is point represents P, nothing but pole, and this point as F focus. Now we are placing the object at focus. This is the object which is placed at focus, and one ray is passing through the center of curvature, and it retraces its same path. This is the center of curvature. Any ray which passes through the center of curvature, it retraces its same path. Another ray which is parallel to the principal axis, this is one more ray, and this is the direction of the incident ray which is parallel to the principal axis, and it reflects, and it reflects on the reflecting surface. The reflector ray, this is the reflector ray which passes through the focus, and this is the direction of the reflector ray, and these two are reflector rays are not meeting at any point, so the image is formed at infinity. So when the object is at F, the image formed at infinity. Okay, this is the object which is placed at F. The two rays are coming from the object. One is a ray passing through center of curvature. It retraces its same path. Another ray which is parallel to the principal axis, and it is the reflector ray passing through focus. These two are the reflector rays. They are not meeting at any point. So the image point at infinity. When the object is at F, the image is formed at infinity. Okay, next case. We'll discuss case 6. When the object is in between P and F. P nothing but pole and F nothing but focus. Let us see the ray diagram. This is concave mirror and horizontal line. This is principal axis. And next point P. P nothing but pole. Pole nothing but geometric center of the spherical mirror is known as pole. And next point F. F denotes the focus and object. Object in between pole and focus. Now we are placing the object. In this case 6, object is placed in between P and F, pole and focus. Next, center of curvature C. Now first ray which is passing through the center of curvature, it retraces its same path. This is the ray which passes through the center of curvature, and it retraces its same path. Incident ray and reflector ray are in the same at center of curvature only. Incident ray, reflector ray, retraces its same path when the light ray is passing through the center of curvature. And next, the second ray which makes an angle with the pole and it reflects with the same angle. This is the direction of incident ray, and this is the reflector ray makes with the same angle. This is the directions. Arrow mark indicates the direction of the reflector ray. This is blue line indicates the incident ray, and the green line indicates the reflector ray. According to laws of reflection, angle of incidence is equals to angle of reflection. And next, these two reflector rays are not meeting at any point. So that's why we are extending the reflected rays. This is the reflector ray, and this is also one more reflector ray. And extending of these two reflector rays, they are meeting at one point. That point, you know, is the image. So this is a virtual image. This is a special case. We are getting the virtual image by using concave mirror. So when the object is placed in between pole and focus, the image formed behind the mirror. The image is virtual, erect and magnified image. So this is the image place. The characteristics of image are, image is virtual and erect and it is magnified image, and the image is formed behind the mirror. This is about the case 6. When the object is placed in between pole and F, one ray is passes through the center of curvature. It retraces its same path. The another ray making an angle with the pole and reflected ray also makes with the same angle. As per the laws of reflection, angle of incidence is equals to angle of reflection. These two reflector rays are not meeting at any point, so they are extending the reflector rays. These extended reflector rays meet at a point, that is the image. So here image is formed behind the mirror. This image is virtual, erect and magnified image, and it is a virtual image and it is formed behind the mirror. This is about the complete cases 1 to 6 in the case of concave mirror. Next we are observing this table regarding the various position of the objects and the formation of the image. Now I'll discuss one by one. First, observe this table carefully. Serial number, position of the object, position of the image, size of the image, nature of the image. Come on, first let us discuss one by one. First one, when the object is at infinity, image formed at the focus, that size of the image is highly diminished and point sized. Image is real and inverted. Now come to the second one. When the object is placed beyond C, image formed in between C and F, the image is diminished. Diminished nothing but small image. The nature of the image is real and inverted. Next, when the object is placed at C, image also formed at C, same size, object size, in this case object size, image size, both are equal. So the image is real and inverted. Come to the fourth one. When the object in between C and F, the position of the image is beyond C, image is formed beyond C, that image is enlarged, nothing but magnified, or the bigger size of the object. Here image is real and inverted. Next one, when the object is at F, image formed at infinity, highly enlarged image, this image is real and inverted. Next, when the object is placed between pole and focus, image formed behind the mirror, the size of the image is enlarged, the image is virtual and erect. In all the 6 cases, only in 6th case the image is virtual and erect. Remaining all 5 cases, image is real and inverted. Okay. So first one, when the object is at infinity, image is formed at focus, real and inverted. Next, beyond C, image formed F and C, image is diminished, real and inverted. When the object is at C, image also at C, same size, real and inverted. When the object in between C and F, image formed beyond C, enlarged, real and inverted. When the object is at F, image formed at infinity, it is highly enlarged, real and inverted. Object is in between pole and F, image formed behind the mirror, and image size of the image is enlarged, and nature of the image is virtual and erect. Next, image formation by a convex mirror. Case 1, when the object is at infinity. Now we'll discuss the ray diagram. This is a convex mirror and this is the principal axis, and then this is the direction of the principal axis, and next point P pole, and next this is center of curvature C. And then now when the object is at infinity, the rays are coming from the sun, they are parallel to the principal axis. This is incident ray, and this is the direction of the incident ray. And next, this is reflecting. Whenever the incident ray falls on the reflecting surface of convex mirror, it reflects. See here, this is a diverging mirror, this is a divergent, and this is the direction of the reflected ray. And then one more ray is, this is also incident ray coming from the sun, and which is parallel to the principal axis, and it is also, this is the direction, direction of the arrow mark indicates the direction of the incident ray. And then this is reflected ray, this is a direction of the reflected ray. These are diverging. Convex mirror is a diverging mirror. It is appeared to meet at a point focus. This is the, we are extending the, these reflector rays, they meet at a point focus. This point denotes the focus. It is denoted by letter F. In a case of convex mirror, the reflector rays are appeared to meet at a point focus F. So this is the image formation, image formed at F. When the object is at infinity, the rays are coming from the sun, they are parallel to the principal axis. In the case of convex mirror, they diverges, and these reflector rays are meet at a point, appear to meet at a point focus F. And the next case 2, when the object is at a finite distance. Now I'll see the ray diagram for the case 2, when the object is at a finite distance. Let us see this ray diagram. Convex mirror and principal axis. This is the horizontal line denotes the principal axis. And this point, midpoint of the spherical mirror is known as pole. It is denoted by letter P. And next, object. Object is at finite distance. This is the object. And incident ray coming from the object falls on the reflecting surface of convex mirror. It reflects. It is a diverging mirror. It diverges. This is the arrow marks for the incident ray. Arrow indicates the direction of the incident ray. And this is reflected ray. This is the arrow indicates the direction of reflector ray. This reflector ray diverges. This reflector ray, extending of reflector ray, meet at a point focus. In the case of convex mirror, reflector ray appear to meet at a point focus F. And one more ray which is passing through the center of curvature, this arrow mark indicates the direction of this incident ray, and which passes through center of curvature, it retraces its same path. This is the normal. We are drawing the normal in between incident ray and reflector ray. This point denotes the center of curvature. This second ray, incident ray, whenever incident ray passes through the center of curvature, it retraces its same path. This arrow mark indicates the retracing the same path. And next, these two reflector rays are meet at a point. This denotes the image. Image is virtual and diminished. Size of the image is small than the object. So this is the second case, in the case of convex mirror, when the object is at finite distance. Now we are placing the object at finite distance. First ray is parallel to the principal axis. It reflects, and extending of reflector ray, and it is appeared to meet at a point focus. The second ray, which is passing through the center of curvature, it retraces its same path. This is the normal. We are drawing the normal, and this is the center of curvature. Normal is drawing the in between incident ray and reflected ray. A perpendicular line which is drawn at the point of incidence. This is known as normal. And next, these two reflector rays are meet at this point. This point denotes the image point. This is the image. This image is too small. That is a diminished image. Image is virtual and diminished image. And image is formed in between pole and focus. When the object is at finite distance, in the case of convex mirror, of image is formed in between pole and focus. Thus, image is virtual and diminished, and it is formed in between pole and F. Next, we'll discuss one table form regarding this object images and position of the image, position of the object. See this table. Position of the object, position of the image, size of the image, nature of the image. First one, when the object is at infinity, image formed at the focus behind the mirror and it is highly diminished point sized. The image is virtual and erect. And this second one is, when the object is in between infinity and the pole of the mirror, the image, the position of the image is in between P and F behind the mirror. Size of the image is diminished, nothing but small. The nature of the image is virtual and erect. In the case of convex mirror, the two cases image is virtual and erect. So convex mirror forms only virtual image. Okay, thanks for watching this video.